Hello friends, so if you are using ChatGPT or any other AI tools or rather AI assisted technology while writing your literature review, research paper, PhD thesis or assignment, then you must know these 5 AI rules, otherwise your manuscript can be rejected or you along with all the co-authors will be blacklisted from that particular journal or you may have to suffer if you are an university student or professor. So hello everyone, I welcome you all to the channel My Research Support. So let us discuss about these 5 AI rules, and if you are following these rules then definitely you can make use of generative AI in your research to speed up your writing process. And under every journal's authors and guidelines section, they have clearly mentioned about these AI rules. So let us now turn towards rule number 1. So you can use generative AI tools like ChatGPT or Quillbot in order to rewrite or rephrase the text, and that is also clearly mentioned by the journals. You can see this. Generative AI and AI assisted technologies should only be used in the writing process to improve the readability and language of the manuscript. That does mean if your English is poor, you can still write your manuscript in your own words, and simply you can rewrite that by using ChatGPT or Quillbot to make it technically strong or to improve the readability and language of the manuscript. But now the question may arise in your mind about the AI score. So obviously, even if you are rewriting your own manuscript, then also it would be detected as AI generated text. See, if you are rephrasing intermittent text, then you need not to worry, means your manuscript won't be detected as AI generated text. But if you are rewriting a bulk text, maybe 3-4 paragraphs at once, then definitely it would be detected as AI generated text. But in that case also you need not to worry. I have mentioned one tool in this video description, you can refer to that. So as of now, that is the best tool to bypass AI detection without compromising in the quality, and its accuracy is really better. And under this rule, one more point is clearly mentioned by all the journals. If you are using generative AI in order to rewrite or rephrase the text, then you have to carefully go through the output text. Otherwise, there may be a mistake in the output text, and if you have submitted that manuscript, if it got published, then as an author, you will be responsible for those mistakes. See this, the technology must be applied with human oversight and control, and authors should carefully review and edit the result, as AI can generate authoritative sounding output that can be incorrect, incomplete or biased. Means authors are ultimately responsible and accountable for the contents of the work. Now let us turn towards rule number 2. So this is regarding authorship and citation. So it is clearly mentioned that authors should not list AI and AI assisted technologies as an author or co-author, nor cite AI as an author. That does mean authorship implies responsibilities and tasks that can only be attributed to and performed by humans. That does mean you cannot put any name of AI tools in the list of authors, and even putting these AI tools or related websites in the references and citing them in text is also not allowed. Now, rule number 3, and which is related to the figures, images and artwork. So there are multiple tools available in the market. With the help of those tools, you can create attractive images, figures and artwork. But before using these tools, you must read this. So most of the journals do not permit the use of generative AI or AI assisted tools to create or alter images in submitted manuscript. There's only exception if the use of AI or AI assisted tools is a part of your research design or research methods, then only you can use it. So simply you cannot use the generative AI tools in order to create any schematic including graphical abstract for your manuscript. Now rule number 4, and which is declaration. So anyhow, if you are making use of these generative AI tools in order to improve the fluency or readability or language of your manuscript, or if you are taking assistance in drafting individual sections of your research documents, then you have to clearly declare that. See what is mentioned. The use of generative AI and AI assisted technologies in scientific writing must be declared by adding a statement at the end of manuscript when the paper is first submitted. The statement will appear in the published work and should be placed in a new section before the references list. That does mean during submission process itself, you will have this option, means you will have separate section where you have to provide this declaration, means you have used which tool and for which purpose. And standard example is also clearly mentioned. You can see this, after your manuscript got published, so this would be the title of new section which would be placed before references. So declaration of generative AI and AI assisted technology in the writing process. And this would be the specific AI tool and related information. Means during the preparation of this work, the authors used ChatGPT or any other AI tool. So here you have to mention the name of AI tool. In order to, you have to mention the reason as well. Means in order to improve the readability, language, etc. After using this tool service, the authors reviewed and edited the content as needed and take full responsibility of the content of the published article. Now let us discuss about the last rule, and that is related to the use of basic tools. So if you are using Grammarly, Mendeley, EndNote, Zotero, maybe for spell check, grammar correction or reference management, then you need not to provide any declaration for their use. You can see this, the declaration does not apply to the use of basic tools such as tools used to check grammar, spelling and reference. If you have nothing to disclose, you do not need to add a statement. So that does simply mean if you have not used any AI tools or AI assisted technology in your writing process, then you need not to provide any statement. So that's it from my side. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope this information will help you. So if you have any queries, do not forget to write us through comments. We'll definitely try to answer all these comments, and do not forget to subscribe this channel. So I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye.